If you register copyright, you can use the registration as a proof in your case.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
Hi, welcome. Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to look at the question, can you get a copyright without registration? What's the benefits of registration? And can you get a copyright? So let's begin. The thing is, in most countries, you do not need to register in order to get a copyright. It's that simple. But the thing is, there are some benefits when you register a copyright. I'm not saying you need to register everything. What I'm saying is, just think about it. If you're really serious about taking some action when someone uses your work or someone copy your work, then if I were you, I would register. So let's talk about it for a little bit. Let's go to the drawing board. I'm going to show you some things and what you need to consider when you're trying to register a copyright. So this is drawing board. Think about it. If you create one picture and you want to register as copyright, you want to protect it, okay, register. But what if you create 1,000 pictures? Can you still register all 1,000? Do you have to pay for the same price for every picture? It's going to cost you more than earning more money when you're trying to protect the picture. So here we have a situation where you only have one, and another situation where we have, let's say, 1,000 or 100 pictures, doesn't matter. Do you have to register every picture? Do you have to pay for every picture? There are some rules about this that you only need to have. When you have a collection, you only need to register the collection. But there are some benefits when you look at registration. When you look at registration, sometimes when you really want to take action against someone and you already registered the copyright, you can use the registration as a proof. So if I register the copyright at an office, I will get the proof that I registered the copyright at that date. And most of the time, in a copyright cases, the date play an important role. So if you have the proof, you can show people the date. And that's really important. So let's say you go to the copyright office, you register, you get the proof. When someone sue you, you can show in the proof that you were the first one. They need to show you the proof that they were before you. And most of the time, it's difficult for them. And if they cannot show you, most time they lose the cases. But I'm not saying a case is only based on the proof. But what I'm saying is, in most situations, if you can prove something, you're good to go. So what are the benefits of registration? Most of the time, people use the benefits just for the proof. So if you register a copyright, you can use the registration as a proof in your case. Most of the time, when people send a summit or a letter, I will ask them always, can you show me the proof that you had copyright on that date? And most of the time they cannot. And then it's going to be a problem for them. Because then they're going to register, but they do not have the date on that time, but they have the date on this time. So registration has benefits, but you do not always need to register copyright. In some countries you need to do, but in most countries you do not need to register copyright. If you have questions about copyright or anything related to copyright, feel free to contact me. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gonna get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be